with its Australian premiere, Hand in God is on its way. It co-stars my next guest, who's online, Jake Speer. Hello, Jake. How are you?
G'day, Leigh. How are you, mate?
Doing well, pal. Doing well. You're going to be a busy man in this. You've gone from kinky boots into something a little bit more kinky, Hand of God.
Something very, very kinky. I'm not quite sure Melbourne is prepared for what's coming for them.
I watched a grab or two on YouTube the other day of this, and I thought, this is a hoot. It was just, look, you couldn't even broadcast it, but it is so, so, so funny. It really is.
It's quite outrageous. I can't wait to get down there and sink my teeth into it.
Mm.
It's going to be absolutely wild, and it's something very different for me. I'm kind of used to playing the sweet boy next door, and now
That's
it's
right.
a chance for me to play the bad boy, I think.
Well, from home and away, you've donned the bad clothes, and there you are down there now.
That's right. I can't wait to play the bad boy bully and sort of be dunking Guyton Grantley's head in toilets and putting chewing gum in his hair and all sorts of things like that.
Oh, he gets the chewing gum too, does he?
Okay. Well, that might be a little special treat. That I
Well, it's this jolly puppet, isn't it? Tell us the storyline. What happens?
Well, it's sort of set in Cypress, Texas, small country town in Texas, and it's all about a little church ministry, and our young hero, Jason, is recently lost his father, and he's sort of grief-stricken, and so is his mother, who's in charge of this little church group, teaching Bible studies to the local kids through puppetry and making puppets. And Jason actually finds out that he's quite good at comedy, quite good at puppetry. The only problem is, the only snag is that the puppet he decides to create ends up being possessed by the devil.
Wow.
And begins to start wreaking havoc on the church pastor, on Jason's love interest, on his mother, and, of course, on Timmy, played by myself.
Yeah. Now, you playing the part of Timmy, I think on YouTube when I watched this, Timmy's on the left-hand side of the puppet, and the puppet's really going hammer and tongs at you. Is that right? That was it, wasn't it?
That's right.
Hammer and
That's
tongs.
Right.
What was it like reading the script for you? Was it funny the first time and get a laugh out of it?
I loved it. I first came across the script about 12 months ago, maybe 18 months ago, and I thought, this has got to be a thing. Someone has to put this on. And then once it came out that Alex and the guys down there in St Kilda were putting it on, I just had to be a part of it. It's a wild play. It throws everyone in the deep end. It's shocking. It's very poignant. It'll definitely prick everyone's interest for sure.
Did you see Book of Mormon?
I do know Book of Mormon very well.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan of Book of Mormon.
Well, the show was excellent, and a laugh a minute, it really, really was. And they're saying that this one, if you love Book of Mormon, you're going to love this. It's even funnier.
Absolutely, absolutely. And even cruder and more shocking, I would argue.
You'd have to argue. I totally believe you. I listen to it. Because I sometimes use grabs on this program to introduce artists, and I thought, I can't introduce you with that grab. I'd have to do too much editing.
That's right. It would just be about a 15-second grab of all beeps. You have to beep out the whole thing.
Yeah, and unfortunately, this is television for imagination. So radio is that, so we can't see the image, otherwise we could have done it. But no, it's a hoot. I can't wait to see this on stage. It's going to be really, really good. When you graduated from NIDA, you were straight into Home and Away at that stage, weren't you?
That's right. That's right. Yeah. I was very blessed, very lucky. I went straight into 3 years on Home and Away here in Sydney with Channel 7. And that was my sort of first experience of working as an actor, straight in front of the camera. Sort of the
ever long to go back to Home and Away?
Well, unfortunately, I don't think I can. They did a very good job of making sure that my character was...
They knocked you off.
...and buried.
But they often bring you back some way, you see. They rise from the dead or something.
Never really know.
No, well, that's right.
30 years of being on TV, we've got to get creative with storylines. So
yes, exactly.
Never say never.
Well, I watch Home and Away. I rather love the show. It's taken a bit of my life now. But you watch that and you think, gee, hasn't even the acting improved? Since it started way, way back 30 years ago, it has just... developed so much and evolved into a beautiful show.
It's pretty incredible, and I think not just performance, but also from a technical perspective as well. You know, with new technology and you know, even the simple things of the transitions between location and set now.
Yes.
You know, people are shocked to realize that you know, their lovely diner or the high school are sets built in a studio. The whole show has really lifted over time, and it's been a great breeding ground
for a whole lot
of Australian talent.
Absolutely. Well, look at yourself too. There you are. You had the start there. You've gone on to great things since then.
Oh, thank you very much.
Yeah, you can keep a barefoot in the bark. That was insane. We didn't get that down in Melbourne, I don't think, barefoot in the park.
No. It had a short run up here in Sydney at the Ensemble. It's a lovely play. It was definitely a play that I've admired for a long time. And Sam Neill's one of my number one favourite playwrights. So it was a joy to do that.
Jake, what were you like at school? Did you do acting at school and part of the school productions and so on?
As much as I could. I grew up in a very small country town in the Riverina,
right,
in New South Wales, and I actually moved out of home when I was 15. I moved away from my family and my small town to pursue and finish my high school at performing arts school in Wagga Wagga.
Right.
They had a theatre there and regular drama performances and productions and things like that. So I was a very ambitious young man. Acting's always been a big part of my life and always something that I knew I wanted to do. So, and then straight after high school completed, I was successful in getting into the full-time acting course at NIDA. Spent 3 years here in Sydney.
Yeah, that's a wonderful story, isn't it? And so young to leave home at 15, that must have been hard for not only yourself, for your parents too, I suppose. But
well,
at 15...
I was very lucky to have extremely supportive parents. Mm. Both of them come from very big sporting families and sporting backgrounds. So when they had their firstborn, thinking that, yeah, great, we'll be taking him to the footy and taking him to the tennis and the soccer and everything.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden this young kid comes out all singing, all dancing with a microphone in his hand. They were like, what do we do with this?
That's right.
But yeah. They were fantastically, wonderfully supportive. They said it was a shock to them, sending their 15-year-old son out into the world a little bit prematurely.
But it must have been hard for you, though, as a 15-year-old leaving home, because normally 18, 20 or something you do it these days, but at 15 you've left home, you've got to get your feet on the ground, perhaps find boarding or living somewhere different. It's a whole new life, isn't it?
Yeah, it was. I'm a romantic at heart, so, the ideas of doing plays and drama classes and stuff was all lovely, but when I rocked up at this sort of boarding house on the hill with all of these other guys, and I've got to try and find buses and cars and get my license and fend for myself and do groceries and make my bed and do my own washing.
Yeah,
What's all of this about,
You've got to become domesticated.
It was for a teenage kid. I had to grow up a little bit. But
mate, there's the training ground, isn't it? And look where you are today. It's just fabulous.
It's a wonderful time.
Yeah. Well, you've got a great play coming up there, Hand of God. What's coming up next for you? You've got something else in the...
I'm actually in pre-production for a short film that I've written and am producing called Inside Water that we're looking to shoot at the end of April. It's something that I've been working on for a few years now.
Right.
It's a short film that we hope to submit into film festivals later in the year. It's a short film about a young farmer who's inherited a failing sheep farm after his father's suicide and has to protect his family's legacy from an increasing threat. His water's been stolen, his sheep are being killed, and he has to do whatever he can to protect that legacy. So something a little darker, something a little more in the vein of No Country for Old Men or Hell or High Water, but we've got a great team assembled and we can't wait to bring that to the world.
Jake, I'll have to look out for that one of the film festivals, Inside Water.
That's right.
Yeah, good on you, mate. Great to catch up, pal. We'll see you on the opening night down there.
Thanks
at the theatre.
So
and Jake, all the best for it. And look, I shouldn't say, but I will say break a leg. Take care, mate.
Okay. There will be plenty of broken bones on the night.
I think there will be. Take care, buddy. Okay.
Thank you, Leigh.
Bye-bye to you.